Good morning from Fort Cochin in Kerala, India. Hey there. Hi, it's been a couple of days since I've been on. Glad I'm back. Traveling on the road. I'm 45 plus days now on the road in South Asia. And yes, I made it to Kerala day before yesterday. At night, in the rain, driving in an old Ambassador. Thank you so much. Kerala is beautiful. I have to tell you that it's almost hypnotic being here. It is, I don't know what it is. There's just something in the air. It's very special here. And what you're looking at right now are the ancient Chinese fishing nets. They've had these nets set up. Now, these are probably been upgraded several times, but they were originally put here 600 years ago. These are an ancient Chinese style of fishing net. It takes at least four men to haul the net up on these cantilevers, and they're lined up all along the beach here. This is a very iconic image of Kerala, particularly Cochin or Fort Cochin or Kochi, as some people call it. Here in Kerala. So it's a very iconic spot and image, and it just shows you the depth of traders that have been here, the Dutch, the Portuguese, and of course, you know, mainly down in this part of India, the Portuguese were, you know, had settled here. So there's much of the architecture reflects that, especially as well in another state in Goa. But I'm further south. I'm deep in South India here. They do kind of look like simplistic cranes as well. And there's a, you know, it has become definitely a tourist attraction here. And they have fishermen that sell live and freshly caught shellfish. Or prawns, crabs, lobsters, or prawns and lobsters, not sure about crabs, and fish. And then you can you can buy it directly from them and then take it to some of the little restaurants here, which will cook it up for you for an additional charge. Hey, Louisiana, and hey, give me a shout out where you are in the world as well so I can say hi through my cracked iPhone 6 Plus screen. And also feel free to share the broadcast, and you can do that just by swiping the screen left to right on iOS and up and down on Android, or just tap the number and you can share that way too. That would be really cool. I spent almost 2 weeks in Mumbai. Oh, that's really nice. Thank you so much. Well, that's what I do. I mean, I travel as much as I can throughout Asia, and I find the places that I really enjoy and like and pass that on, and hopefully you'll be inspired maybe one day to come here as well. Hello, Sacramento. So I do really appreciate that comment. That's really nice. And that's really what I'm trying to do here, is find some of the best things and make those suggestions to you, because, you know, not everybody has the time like me. Not everybody can spend almost 2 weeks in Mumbai, so I can stay there and find the best things for you guys to see and pass on. Yeah, the backwaters definitely are on my trip. I've rented a motorbike here, and there is one beach that I'm going to head out to. It's about 25 kilometers away. And it's right in the heart of the backwaters as well. My best part of Mumbai, well, a couple of things. I loved the street food of Mumbai. I love that culture. I just love the street food, how everybody gathers on the street, no matter what walk of life, lawyers, you know, everyday working people, and they all gather together and eat this amazing street food. I love that. Hey, Tennessee. And okay, well, watch on Catch as well. They're all on Catch, so I love that. And of course, I love all of the old architecture and how it's been preserved. It is absolutely amazing. Fort and Churchgate, a couple of my favorite places there in Mumbai. So really love that. And Kerala, I've just only been here a couple of days. Hello, Seattle. And but I really like it. I was starting to describe it as being sort of almost hypnotic, because it's the heat, it's the humidity, and the spices that you can smell in the air. Yes, I did try pav bhaji. I love pav bhaji. I love vadapav. Vadapav was one of my favorite street foods, and I love belpuri and sabpuri. I love all that stuff, so I really enjoyed that culture of street food in Mumbai. Just love that. And so I'm just finding that it's, I feel like I'm in a movie here. I feel like I could write a book because the intensity of this place is hypnotic, and you can see it just in this in these fishing nets. And if I could describe to you the smells, it's absolutely amazing. Pani puri is my favorite. Oh, cool. I'm just going to walk down. I'm going to just crawl over these rocks here and give you just a little bit of a different perspective. This is not a beach reflective of beaches of Kerala, by the way. This is kind of a well-trodden area. So if it doesn't look super spectacular, this is not reflective of what the beaches are like here in Kerala. But here's another shot from looking down the channel here at these amazing fish nets. West Coast is where it all started, yeah. And so these are these amazing fish nets here. And this is, like I said before, a very iconic image of Kerala. And I'm just going to the cranes. Well, this is a big shipping area, so that's a container port there. And this is like looks like an old fishing net that's been kind of put out to pasture, so to speak. I came down here last night, and just the sunsets are just amazing. I was trying to upload some pictures last night on Facebook, and you can follow me on Facebook to see some of the images that I'm taking here as I travel. And yes, these were Chinese contributions, absolutely. So if you follow me on Facebook, Far East Adventure Travel, that would be great. And I'm not going to be in India for a long time. I usually make it a point of getting off the travel road, during the Christmas break. I'll just give you a couple of reasons. One is the prices go up, and I don't need a Christmas vacation. So I've been traveling for over 45 days now. Haven't tried Daba food, no. I usually get off because the rates go up. It's more crowded. Some of these places do take on a different mode because a lot of people come down here, especially South India, from Europe, the UK, and becomes a definitely it change the mood changes somewhat in these places. So I try to get off the road before Christmas. Okay, I will try that for sure. Thank you. Thanks for the suggestion. And so I probably will finish up my trip by the middle of the month. I'll stay here for at least a week, and then I'll head down to Trivandrum. And I'll stay in Trivandrum for a few days. That is probably the biggest city at the southern end of the country. And then, oh, that's great. Thank you so much. Thanks, Russ. And then I'll head back to Taiwan after that. It'll be almost it'll be close to a month that I would have been in India. So this is about a month turn, which is about regular for me. The first time I came to India, I was here for 2 months, and this time it'll be about a month. Oh, sorry, I missed the Kerala. Sorry. Oh, no Daba here. Okay. Well, I'll have to try it when I'm back in Mumbai again. But I do enjoy the food of Kerala. Kerala seafood is just outstanding. No, I haven't seen that, but I will check it out. I will definitely check it out. I mean, I've seen other people like Bourdain visiting here, and so I will check out some of the street food here as well. And I had a Carolyn breakfast this morning. I had some curry vegetable and appam. And appam is it's a pancake made out of fermented rice and coconut milk. And it just goes really perfect. It soaks up the sauce of the curry, and it's really tasty. So that's what I had this morning. And then I love this because this place reminds me of Sri Lanka in a lot of ways. The culture, I think, or the just everything, there's a similar feel for sure. And but what I like is that they give me coconut milk on the side with my coffee if I ask for it, which is really nice because I don't drink regular milk. So I enjoy coconut milk with coffee. And I had an iced coffee yesterday with coconut milk and honey, which was absolutely delicious. And after I get off the Periscope here, I'm going to do some shopping and get some fresh fruit. I saw a truck full of just beautiful pineapples yesterday that I've got my eye around here that I'll be scoping from. Mattancherry is one. There's a place called Jewtown with a very old synagogue in it that is just a short hop away, and then I'm going to be heading down to the beach. So I'll be periscoping all from here, and I hope you enjoy me. But join me, not enjoy me. You can enjoy me if you want. And I really appreciate you following me. And don't forget to follow me on Facebook. It's Far East Adventure Travel, and my Nepal page as well, Far East Adventure Travel Nepal, and updates from my friend Sindh Palchuk district. The village there is Tangpulkot One, and I'll be sharing updates on my Nepal page as well. So I really appreciate that. And you can also subscribe to my podcast. It's called Far East Adventure Travel. I uploaded one on Mumbai the other day, just a quick walking tour around Mumbai, which was a lot of fun. And I'll probably put up another one in a couple of days on my first impressions of Kerala. So, and I see this big, this looks like a tour group or something. All of a sudden they've clambered down here. But these are the big giant fishing nets. This is absolutely, if you Google Cochin or Fort Kochi, this is the image that's going to come up. And people tend to be, it's definitely a different feel in the south. I mean, it's not as crowded here, so that has a lot to do with it. It's not as busy. Kerala has been a well-managed. Well, it's actually a democratically elected communist party that has been running Kerala here for a number of years. I don't have all of the exact dates. And they have some really phenomenal results for graduation from schools and their reading and writing.